Hey tech enthusiasts, welcome to New Tech Explained, where we explore the cutting edge of technology and how it's shaping our future. Today we're diving into something straight out of a sci-fi movie, brain-computer interfaces or BCIs. Imagine controlling your computer, prosthetic limb, or even a drone, just by thinking about it. Sounds like magic, right? Well, it's not. It's science, and it's happening right now. But before you start worrying about hackers reading your thoughts, don't panic. We're here to break it all down for you. By the end of this video, you'll know what BCIs are, how they work, and how they're already changing the world. Stay tuned to discover how BCIs are turning science fiction into reality and how you might soon control devices with your mind. Let's get started. So what exactly is a brain-computer interface? Simply put, it's a direct communication pathway between your brain and an external device. Think of it as a translator that converts your brain's electrical signals into commands a computer can understand. There are three main types of BCIs, invasive BCIs. These are implanted directly into the brain. They're often used for medical purposes like helping paralyzed patients control robotic limbs. For example, BrainGate has developed an invasive BCI that allows patients with severe paralysis to control computers, robotic arms, and even their own wheelchairs, just by thinking. It's like giving them a new lease on life. Partially invasive BCIs. These sit on the surface of the brain. They're less risky than fully invasive systems but still require surgery. A great example is synchron stentrode, a device that's placed in a blood vessel near the brain. It's less invasive than traditional implants but still powerful enough to help paralyzed patients control computers and devices with their thoughts. It's like having a brain implant without the major surgery. Non-invasive BCIs. These use external devices like EEG headsets to measure brain activity. No surgery required, just pop it on your head and go. Companies like Emotive and Neuroscience make EEG headsets that let you control games, meditate more effectively, or even monitor your focus levels. Another cool example is Neurable's BCI-powered VR games, where you can control the game environment just by thinking. It's like magic, but it's science. Which type of BCI do you think is the most fascinating? Comment below. Now, you might think BCIs are a recent invention, but they've actually been around since the 1970s. Back then, researchers were just starting to experiment with brain signals to control external devices. Fast forward to the 1990s, and we saw the first major breakthrough, a paralyzed patient successfully controlling a computer cursor with their mind. Since then, the field has exploded with advancements, thanks to companies like Neuralink, Synchron, and BrainGate. It's like we're living in the future, but the future started a while ago. Let's get a little technical, but don't worry, we'll keep it fun. BCIs work by detecting and interpreting the electrical signals your brain produces. These signals are picked up by electrodes, which can be inside your brain, on its surface, or even outside your skull. Think of BCIs as a magical translator that turns your thoughts into actions, like a wizard casting spells with their mind. For example, if you think about moving your right hand, your brain sends specific signals. A BCI can detect those signals and translate them into actions, like moving a robotic arm or typing on a keyboard. It's like having a superpower, except instead of flying, you're just really good at texting without your hands. And here's the kicker, BCIs aren't just one-way streets. Some systems can also send signals back to your brain, creating a feedback loop. Imagine feeling the texture of a virtual object in a VR game just by thinking about it. Mind-blowing, right? Alright, let's talk about the real-world applications of BCIs. Because this isn't just cool tech, it's life-changing tech. BCIs are revolutionizing healthcare in ways that were once unimaginable. For paralyzed individuals, BCIs offer a chance to regain control over their bodies. Imagine being able to move a robotic arm, type on a computer, or even walk again, all by thinking about it. Companies like BrainGate have already enabled patients to control robotic limbs and communicate using their thoughts. But it doesn't stop there. BCIs are also being used to restore speech for people who have lost the ability to talk. Researchers are developing systems that can translate brain signals into synthesized speech, giving a voice to those who conditions like ALS or stroke have silenced. And let's not forget about treating neurological disorders. BCIs are being used to manage conditions like Parkinson's disease, epilepsy, and even chronic pain. By modulating brain activity, these systems can reduce symptoms and improve quality of life. It's like having a remote control for your brain. BCIs are helping scientists unlock the secrets of the brain. How do we process information? How do we learn? How do emotions work? By studying brain activity in real time, researchers are gaining unprecedented insights into these questions. For example, BCIs are being used to study how the brain adapts to new tasks, which could lead to better educational tools or rehabilitation techniques. They're also helping us understand conditions like Alzheimer's and schizophrenia, paving the way for new treatments. What if you could boost your memory, focus, or even learn new skills faster? BCIs are making this a reality. Researchers are exploring how BCIs can enhance cognitive abilities, from improving attention spans to speeding up language learning. Some studies are even looking at brain-to-brain communication, where thoughts are shared directly between two people. Imagine collaborating on a project without saying a word, just by thinking about it. It's like telepathy, but with science instead of magic. Gamers, this one's for you. BCIs are taking gaming to a whole new level. Imagine controlling your character in a video game or navigating a virtual reality environment just by thinking about it. Companies like Neurable are already developing BCI-powered games that let you interact with the virtual world using your mind. And it's not just about gaming, BCIs are also being used in immersive entertainment experiences, like virtual concerts or interactive movies. Imagine feeling the emotions of a character in real time or controlling the plot of a story with your thoughts. The possibilities are endless. The military is always on the cutting edge of technology, and BCIs are no exception. Researchers are exploring how BCIs can enhance soldier performance, from improving reaction times to reducing mental fatigue. BCIs are also being used to control drones and other unmanned vehicles. Imagine a pilot controlling an entire fleet of drones, just by thinking about it. It's like something out of a sci-fi movie, but it's happening right now. And let's not forget about communication. BCIs could enable soldiers to communicate silently and instantly, without the need for radios or other devices. It's a game changer for battlefield coordination. Now let's talk about the future, because BCIs are just getting started. Imagine a world where BCIs allow us to download skills directly into our brains. Want to learn French? Just download it. Need to play the guitar like a rock star? Done. We could even see brain-to-brain communication, where thoughts are shared instantly. No words needed. It's like telepathy, but with Wi-Fi. What do you think about the idea of downloading skills directly into our brains? Exciting or scary? Let me know in the comments. But with all these exciting possibilities come some serious ethical questions. Could BCIs be used for mind control or surveillance? What happens if someone hacks into your brain and steals your thoughts? And who gets access to this technology? Will it only be for the wealthy, or will it be accessible to everyone? These are big questions, and they don't have easy answers. But one thing's for sure, as BCIs evolve, we need to have these conversations to ensure the technology is used responsibly and ethically. Of course, BCIs aren't perfect yet. Interpreting brain signals is tricky, because every brain is unique, like a fingerprint. There's also the challenge of latency, or delays between thought and action. And let's not forget, using a BCI often requires a lot of training. So, no, you won't be controlling drones with your mind tomorrow, but maybe someday. If you're a fan of sci-fi, you've probably seen BCIs in action, sort of. Think The Matrix, where Neo learns Kung Fu by downloading it into his brain, or Avatar, where humans control alien bodies with their minds. While we're not quite there yet, real-world BCIs are making these ideas less fiction and more reality. Who knows, maybe one day, you'll be downloading Kung Fu skills too. So, what do you think about brain-computer interfaces? Are you excited about the possibilities, or are you a little nervous about the risks? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on the next tech breakthrough. And hey, if you have any ideas for future videos, drop them in the comments too. Thanks for watching New Tech Explained, and remember, the future isn't just coming, it's already here. See you in the next one.